Hi you guys, it's Tam the Storyteller, and I wanted to thank everyone who recently subscribed, and everyone who had not recently subscribed. All my subscribers, thank you. Especially Hot for Words, because she featured me in one of her videos, and now I have, like, 15 more subscribers than I had before. For a person who only has 25 subscribers, that's an incredibly good thing. So, thank you. Today I wanted to tell you guys the story of Little Fingerling, so I'll just begin. Once upon a time, in old Japan, there lived a childless couple. Every year they prayed at the shrine, "Oh please, give us a child, even a child no bigger than the tip of my finger." And, ironically so, they were given a child, no bigger than the tip of the wife's smallest finger. When he was a year old, he only grew to be as big as her thumb, and by the time he was 10 years old, he was only as big as his father's tallest, finger. So, they named him Little Fingerling, or Isinboshi in Japanese. He worked hard, and he grew up happy and strong, working in his mother's kitchen preparing vegetables, and in his father's garden picking weeds. But when he was 15 years old, Isinboshi decided, "I'm a man, I must seek out the world." His parents were terrified. "How will you get around? People will trample you, no one will be able to see you." But Isinboshi would not be discouraged. "A man must seek out anything, no matter his obstacles," he said. So his mother gave in and made him a fine traveling costume out of an old scrap of brocade. And his father made him a straw scabbard for his tiny little sword, which was one of his mother's sewing needles. They gave him a rice bowl and a pair of chopsticks, and he went on his way. It took him quite a long time to get to the to get down the road, for he was so small. But once he got to the end of the road, he met a river. He put his rice bowl into the river, and paddled with his chopsticks until at last he could see the golden tiles of the city of Kyoto. He was quite impressed with himself for getting past the river, and when he got into the town, he sat down on the stall of one of the shop owners. This shop owner was a seller of boxes and combs, and as soon as his first customer saw Isinboshi sitting on one of his boxes, a crowd started to gather around the shop. "Look at the little man," the crowd said. And the shop owner, seeing his opportunity, said, "Why, fine people, if you wish to see this fine and unusual sight, you may as well buy some of my products." And the crowd happily agreed, buying many boxes and combs. At the end of the day, the shop owner, quite happy with Isinboshi, said, "You must stay here and work for me. I'll gather quite the market if you sit here day in and day out and act as an amusement." Isinboshi said, "Well, sir, I can't just sit around. Please allow me to give you some real work." And Isinboshi said, "I can paint fine designs on your combs." The shop owner agreed to let him stay there, giving him room and board, and letting him paint combs in the shop stall. One day, a rich lady came along looking to buy a comb for her eldest daughter. And when she saw Isinboshi, she said, "Oh, please, sir, you must come to my household." Isinboshi wasn't quite sure, but looking at the shop owner said, "I can do no more for you. You'd seek your fortune much better if you were in the house of a powerful family." Isinboshi agreed and he went with the rich lady, with whom had just bought her comb. So, you guys, I'm going to do this in two parts, so I'll give you the second half of Little Fingerling later. Bye.